Take a look at the West standings and see who else these guys feel might be in that category of, boy, they could go either way here as we hit the second half of the season. Let's keep it in the West. What team comes to mind?
The one that I think is a really decent team but is up against it because they're in the Central Division is Minnesota. I mean, they've got a lot of good veterans. They have Zach Parise playing the way that he's capable of. He looks like he's injury-free this year. Looks like the back is loosened up and he's ready to go. They've got a lot of veterans on the blue line, including Ryan Suter. And they've got good goaltending as well. They're a tricky team this year. And they also have a head coach in Bruce Boudreau that they've stuck with, even though it's a new general manager in Bill Guerin. They stayed patient with him. He's got an incredible record of winning during the regular season. So I can't rule Minnesota out of the picture. I think they are quietly sneaking up on teams, but I think they're a really good team and would not be shocked for a second if they make it. The only issue I have is the teams that are ahead of them in the Central Division. They're only going to make it if they get the wild card. They're not going to get past St. Louis. They're not going to get past Colorado. I mean, those teams are up there, and Dallas as well. They're not going to beat those three teams out. So they have to make it as a wild card team.
And the other two teams in that division are in the hunt as well. Nashville, we touched on them. I think they get a little boost with the new head coach and make it interesting. And the Chicago Blackhawks. Jeremy Colliton's been the head coach for over a year now. They've had enough of a sample size to see what it's all about there. And you continue to see a good week of hockey, a terrible week of hockey, a great week of hockey, a bad week of hockey. Very inconsistent. Now is the time, second half of the season, do the Hawks finally get it together? They've got strong goaltending. Doesn't matter who plays, Leonard or Crawford. Their defense has a bunch of young kids that they're kind of letting run right now. It'll be interesting to see how they perform down the stretch. But we talk about getting Connor McDavid and Nathan MacKinnon in the playoffs. How about Patrick Kane? That's a guy that needs to be on center stage in the playoffs every year. One of the most fun players to watch in all of hockey, and he's even better in the postseason.
It's remarkable when you look at the standings and you look at that Central Division, and Chicago's only a couple points behind Nashville. You can understand why Peter Laviolette was removed. They're 1 point behind Nashville. And you're in Chicago, and that team's under heat. They're, you know, being destroyed through the media that the team's no good, and look where they are. I mean, they're still in the hunt.
Yeah.
Like you can mention them, and it's not a ridiculous mention that Chicago finds a way to make it to the playoffs, and that's why Nashville is in the situation where they have a new head coach right now, because on paper, they're in a lot different place than the Hawks are right now as far as where the expectations are. Nashville's supposed to make the playoffs. Nashville's a team that you talk about before the season starts, and you could have made, you know, a legitimate argument that they'd be one of the teams to make it to the Stanley Cup final if you were, you know, picking the two teams to meet in the final. Nashville would not have been a ridiculous choice.
Right.
But they've become that based upon where they're sitting in the standings.
Well, it's a fun conversation to have, considering where we are hitting the second half of the season. It could really go either way for so many of these teams. Let's keep it right there and move from the West and go back to the East and think about the same topic here, Jonesy. Teams that you want to get up and say, you know what, I see them getting in, or this team is going to go the other direction right now.
Well, for me, it's Florida. They're in right now. They're tied with the Flyers, but I think Joel Quenneville has taken the first half of the season to get to know his team, which a great head coach will do. I think Bobrovsky has not played to his potential in goal yet. His save percentage is still below 900. He's been looking really weak at times, and you would expect that to turn around as he gets more comfortable in a new city. He was in Columbus for a long time, and that can happen with a player who's all of a sudden brought in, paid a lot of money, and is supposed to take the franchise to a new level. It hasn't happened early. Once he gains some confidence, I think Florida takes off. They have so many good players in their lineup, and they've got a great coach behind the bench. So Florida, to me, is a playoff team. But they're also in an extremely tough division, with Tampa now starting to play up to their potential. Toronto's been on fire since the coaching change. They just continue to have the challenge of trying to catch teams like Boston as well. So that'll be one to really interest me in the second half of the season. But I think they get there.
I think they do too. Florida, if they can hold a playoff spot at the midway point of the season with their best player in Bobrovsky playing the way he is, you got to think it's only going to get better. A full season with Joel Quenneville behind the bench, learning where those shots are going to come from. That was a big thing that Joel stresses, is you're going to give up something sometimes. Let's give up a shot where the goalie knows where it's coming. He's only maybe got half the net to shoot on. Those are things that you work out as the season goes along. Joel's a new coach, Bobrovsky, new team. It's a whole new situation for him, but enough's enough. He's got to start playing better in these big games down the stretch. We saw how important he was for Columbus last year, And speaking of Columbus, we got to mention the Blue Jackets, don't we? I mean, I always talk about the injuries in Pittsburgh and what a great job Mike Sullivan's doing as the head coach of the Penguins, getting them to a 55-point season at the midway point. But how about Columbus? They've got just as many injuries. They got fewer superstars in Columbus, and they keep chugging along, winning games, point streak after point streak. I wouldn't mind a few ugly losses in Columbus just so we could get John Tortorella in the postgame scrum angry. But I like Columbus's team, always a hardworking blue-collar team. And as you mentioned, second half of the season, these games tighten up. It's more of a playoff feel. That's Columbus's brand of hockey right now.
Great blue line in Columbus, and that's a big strength of their team. But they've been missing so many top players. We know all the players they lost after the season ended last year, and Panarin, Bobrovsky, who you just mentioned, some real super, and Matt Duchene, who moved on to Nashville. So you would have expected the team to really drop back. I think they're 5 points behind their pace of last season. It's absolutely remarkable, the job that John Tortorella has done and the job that the players have done that have been asked to step up and perform at a higher level than they ever have before. They're enjoying the challenge. The expectations are low, and they have really bonded together there in Columbus and done an outstanding job for their fan base.
How about the team that was just below them in the standings there, Buffalo? They've been up, they've been down, they've stayed down. Do they have enough Sharpie to make a run here these last 3 months?
I don't think so. Too many issues all throughout the lineup, to be quite honest with you. When I watch a Sabres game, I just wait for number 9 to get on the ice and show me something. And Jack Eichel, that's about all they have, in my opinion. I like Ralph Kruger behind the bench. Had a chance to work with him through Hockey Canada a few times at different tournaments. I think he's got a great mind for the game, and I think there are brighter days ahead. But right now, there's too many holes to compete with the teams that are ahead of them. If they're going to go on a serious run, how much better is Eichel really going to play? How many more players can he put on his back? He's been fun to watch. I just don't think Buffalo has enough.
There's some players there that you're waiting to get going, Jeff Skinner being one of them. Rasmus Dahlin on the back end, who has had some injury issues this year, but has not looked as great as I thought he would at this point in his career, because he's got his feet wet now. Mm-hmm. You're waiting for him to take the next step. Rasmus Ristolainen can play well at times. He's played better this year than he did last year. And you look at some of the depth on the back end, and you think, okay, their blue line looks a lot better than it has and in recent seasons, but the forwards to me are lacking. Mm-hmm. And it is the Jack Eichel show. Give him a ton of credit for keeping that team in the spot that they're in the standings. Without him, they're down with the Red Wings.
Yeah.
I mean, that's how far they drop off without a star player like Eichel and a guy that's really taken ownership of that team.
It makes you wonder, like, this Rasmus Dahlin still getting his feet wet at the NHL level. It's tough for a defenseman. Right? They don't jump into the league right away and do what Cale Makar does, unless you're Cale Makar. But what if Dahlin was in Colorado in Makar's spot, passing to MacKinnon and Rantanen on the power play, feeling that confidence of being on a top team? It's not easy when you're playing on a bad team and you're a defenseman fishing the puck out of your net every time you're on the ice. It's not a great way to develop. So for Buffalo's sake, let's get this guy going a little bit, Dahlin. As soon as he turns the corner and becomes a superstar that everybody thinks he's going to be after being drafted first overall, now you got some pieces to work with.